Charlene, I know you and I pray for our kids and our grandkids, and that's part of what this service really is all about, right, Pastor Michelle? And one of the things that we do, not only praying for our kids and grandkids, we pray for all children. And one of the things that we do on Tuesday morning, the Tuesday turnaround, comes from 1 Kings 17, where Elijah was given a dead boy. And he said, "Give me your son." And he took the child's body from the widow's arms, carried him up the steps to the room where he was staying, laid the boy's body on the bed. He stretched himself over the child three times and cried out to the Lord, "O Lord my God, please let this child's life return to him." The Lord heard Elijah's prayer, and the life of the child returned, and he revived, and Elijah brought the child to his mother. We do the same thing even on Tuesday mornings, where we pray for those children who may look dead spiritually. And we're believing, as we continue to pray once, twice, three times, the Lord is hearing our prayer. God is bringing life back to the children of this next generation. So you may feel as if you've lost your child to the devil. The culture has stolen your child. College or high school or elementary education is stolen your child, because the culture is pulling our children away from Jesus and the church. But we believe through our prayers that God is restoring the life of the dead back to life and bringing them to the place of a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. And that's why we're holding these services. Praise the Lord, Pastor Michelle. God bless you.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Hope Christian Church. My name is Michelle Jackson. I am the senior pastor of Hope Christian Church, and I am joined tonight by my friend and sister, Doe Jones. We are going to continue our conversation that we were having last week. I know that so many people were freed last time. So if you were not with us last week, you need to watch the last time, because this was an awesome, sincere time of just sharing the goodness of the Lord. Mm-hmm. And I know that there are many who received fresh vision, fresh insight for their life and moving forward. It reminds me of that Israel song, moving forward, not going back, moving ahead. So we are going to get into it tonight, but I want to pray for you before we start, because one of the topics that we're going to be talking about tonight is the idea that performance, or our need to acquire the Lord's love, sometimes can be misguided, because he's already affirmed us and loved us with an everlasting love when we were yet sinners. And so we want to talk about it from different angles, about how the enemy uses it now as a trap because of the generation we live in. So I know that you're going to see some things within your own heart and your own life as Doe shares her testimony, but also I'm going to share some things too. So it's going to be awesome. So let's just pray, and then we're going to enter into worship. Lord, I just thank you tonight for what you're doing in our church. God, many are the plans of a man's heart, but you order our steps. So even when we are planning different events or services or different things, God, you lead us in the midst of it. So, Lord, for those who thought tonight they would just come on, Lord, I know that you have a word for them. You have a gift for them. Lord, you have insight for them. You have revelation for them. So, Lord, I pray that this would not just be another gathering, another time to have a service, but, Lord, we pray that each one who watches this service would encounter your presence, your word that divides between truth and lies, and that, Lord, this would be a life-giving opportunity for them to encounter our risen Savior. We thank you, God, for what you're doing in this time. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. So let's enter into worship with our team. And when we come back, we're going to be talking about overcoming performance.
have your way tonight. Hallelujah. Why don't you do what you want to do? Come and move how you want to move. Why don't you say what you want to say? Come and have your way. Why don't you do what you want to do? Lord, come and move how you want to move. Why don't you say what you want to say? Come and have your way. Why don't you
do what you want to do?
Lord, come and
move how you want to move.
Why don't you
say what you want to say?
Come and have your way.
Why don't you
do what you want to do?
Lord, come and
move how you want to move.
Lord, just you
say what you want to say.
Come and have
stay right there, stay right there.
Why don't you
do what you want to do?
Come and move it.
Say what you
want to
say.
Come and have
your way. Lord, why don't you
do what you want to do?
Yes, come and
move how you want to move.
Lord, just
say what you want to say.
Come and have your way.
'Cause you are my
one desire.
You are my
one desire.
You are my
one desire.
So come and have
what we're here for. Yes, Jesus, we love you. Oh, this is what we came for, and this is what we're here for. Oh, Jesus, we love you. Now say that together. So this is what we came for.
This is what we came for.
This is what we're here for.
This is what we're here for.
So Jesus, we love you.
Jesus, we love you.
From the bottom of our hearts, Lord God, this is what we came for.
This is what we came for.
Shout it out, shout it out. This is what we came for.
This is what we came for.
thank you so much for being here again, because we just have such life-giving conversations, and I know that just being able to record this is going to help a lot of people. So there is a song on your new EP that we love, well, that I love. I'm speaking for you at home. You love it too, even if you haven't heard it yet.
Tell
but
them
anyhow,
what they love.
I love it. And talk a little bit about it, and talk to us about how you wrote it. From this performance aspect.
Yeah, I mean, the song is called "I Try." It's about, it's actually my journey of being freed of feeling that performance can buy me love, and God revealing that to me. And me shedding that, you know, over time. And yes, and that was a heavy, heavy revelation. And it's been a deep healing for me, deep, deep.
When I came to the understanding, well, I was listening to your song actually, and I came to the understanding that the Lord really wanted this generation, and for women in particular, to know that the rejections that we've dealt with in life, even as women of color, that the pains that we've gone through, the things that brought shame in our life, that he's not that person.
Right.
And I know so many of us can have transactional relationships with the Lord. You know, I tithe, so I receive this. Or I serve in my church, so I expect this back. But that love of a father that covers, that affirms without an agenda, that sees into your heart and knows before you speak a word, many of us have never experienced that. And so we go through life performing.
Yeah. Yeah, I think, you know, obviously, I think for every Black woman, right, there is going to be a level of performance that they're going to have to shed, because for us and for really everyone in the world, there's like a level of upkeep that will allow you to be accepted by a certain level of society.
No, don't talk about my breasts. Don't talk about my hair.
What? You look so good.
No, I'm just saying that some of us still buy into that.
We still buy into it, yes.
Right? And that straight is the right way.
And you should straighten if you want to.
Exactly.
But never because you feel more accepted, right?
Exactly.
And I have a length check really soon. I want to see how long my hair is, so I'll be straightening pushpin. But I, you know, I couldn't figure out, like, where was the seed planted? Where did the enemy take the dagger and drive it in for me with this whole performance thing? I needed God to take me on that journey. And but he didn't show me exactly, you know, what it was until I said yes to the journey, like we talked about last week. And allowed him to heal me at his pace. See, I wanted to know in one moment, like, let's just do this. I have time for it right now. I've made space for this healing in this moment. But God has time, and Jesus has time for true healing, and he heals at his pace. Regardless of how fast we want it to happen or when we want to know, what is it, God? He takes his time, because he knows if he uproots everything all at once, it'll kill us, right? He's an incredible gardener. So anyway, he, you know, started taking me on this sweet journey. And every time I think I was healed, one more thing would pop up. And I remember being in my car after a good morning of prayer. I'm in Tulsa, singing at a church, and God just drops it on me. And he's like, this is where it happened for you. I grew up in the South at a church with incredible pastors, but it was a Southern church. And in the South, racism is less subvert and more in your face than anywhere else in the United States, unless it's Idaho. And so I went to a church with people whose primary battle was that race thing. And there were years in my life, and I've since, you know, processed this with my pastors, and we're, you know, open, I'm open with talking about it. But there were people that I would see in church who would say, oh, I just love you and, you know, your family. And I would see them out, and it was a total switch up, right?
Wow.
They don't see me. they have to explain why they know me to the other white people at the table. And so for that amount of years, I was buying love with performance. People were tolerating me. Not everyone. I know I was surrounded by loving people, but there were people who tolerated me because of my gifting, because of my ability to perform. And I didn't realize that that took a toll on me and further drove that dagger in and even caused me to see the Father differently. Because in ministry, sometimes you just get over things, but you don't walk through it because you got to move on. And so this was God taking me back around and saying, let me hold your hand and walk you through this and help you see why you feel like performance will buy you love. Why you can't walk into a room with ministers and fully be yourself until they've heard you sing, right? Maybe then they'll accept all of me if they, does that make sense?
It does.
Yeah, so.
But you just said something so powerful.
Yeah.
That in ministry, you have to often get over things quickly.
Yes.
To do what's needed, but you don't walk through them.
Mm-hmm.
It's important that we understand that, yes, the Lord wants us to quickly forgive, and that oftentimes is an act of our will, but that he does want our heart
Absolutely.
To be right. And that's the process part that you're talking about, right?
Yeah.
It's like doing the right thing is so important, but also being the right person.
Yes.
Like coming from the right heart.
Right?
Right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And so he had to walk me through it.
Wow.
And so I've been in this other beautiful journey of realizing that if people were saying that they did love me back then, I honestly didn't even really give them a chance because I wasn't introducing them to me.
Mm.
I was introducing them to the part that I knew they would accept.
The part that you perceived would be palatable, the part of you that you think that could be tolerated, almost as if, and it's so interesting how rejection creeps, the spirit of rejection creeps into our
yes.
lives, because it's almost as if you knew the real me, then this wouldn't be real for you.
Exactly, which kept me from real and genuine relationship.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember the moment that I had that beautiful conversation with my pastors, who they've given me permission to talk about it. And afterwards realizing, I can't believe how much closer I actually feel to them.
Mm-hmm.
Like I thought, because I'd been walking around and saying, oh yes, I, you know, I love them and I know they love me. And God was like, if that were true, then you would be able to trust them with this.
Yeah.
And so I had to have that conversation, and it was such a beautiful moment of reconciliation, but it was also like another form of, hi, I'm Doe. Nice to meet you. And you just don't know the chasm that the enemy has created until you really do uncover all of that and just bring yourself to the table, your actual self to the table. And that's what that moment was for me. And I feel like my relationships are deeper now, right? Because, and you know, there's always gonna be some element of trying to figure out how to manage relationships, because there are some relationships in your industry, in my industry actually, that are transactional, and it's God using you for that person's benefit or God using them for your, and you gotta be okay with how God does relationships. But also, now I'm not afraid to actually be in true relationship because I'm bringing Doe and Dominique really to the table.
Dominique.
That's my name. Yeah, so it's gonna be this balancing act. And for those of you who wanna be in the music industry or any industry that causes you to use your physical self or any ability that you have as a career, you really need to yield that part of your life to God. Everyone does.
Mm-hmm.
But this is a place that the enemy can use to keep you in a certain place and keep you from experiencing true and genuine and loving relationship, which is community at its finest. It's people seeing you and loving you off the stage, right?
Yeah, like in your actual life, not just on platforms or interviews or whatever. It's so important that we have that support, because when life happens to everybody, the Bible says that the rain falls on the just and the unjust. And so even when you get to a place of success, You still need people because storms will come. And Jesus will be with you, but he's also assigned us to be a part of a church, to be a part of the church. And so that means that we're a part of the relationship network that mm-hmm. is the body of Christ. Mm-hmm. And a lot of us, we haven't experienced healthy church life, or we've had wounds at church. And instead of really allowing ourselves to recognize our even holding on or contribution to those moments, we often push church people or the church, we hold them at an arm's length.
Yeah.
Or as some people say, deal with them with a long-handled spoon. We do that because we now are invested in our own protection, self-preservation.
Yeah.
And then that just perpetuates the cycle.
Yeah.
So I think it's so important that we recognize those moments, those breaches, so that we can really allow the Lord to walk us through a process of healing. Sometimes it's our own misunderstanding.
Yeah.
And like you were saying, your perception of things got adjusted.
Yeah.
But oftentimes these things were very real that happened to us.
Absolutely.
And it was not our fault. But in our desire to protect ourselves, we cause ourselves to then take on the Lord's job.
Right.
Because he's our protection.
Right.
He vindicates our name. Mm-hmm. He protects us from the enemy. But when we are so invested in protecting ourselves, and we're doing something that God wants to do for us and give us mm-hmm. so that we can invest our heart mm-hmm. and our emotions mm-hmm. and our mindset mm-hmm. in other things.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And that's the thing, is it puts a lid on, right? Your ability to grow in love, your ability to grow in trust, your ability to give someone what you would want from them. It puts a lid on it. And to me, all of those things are all wrapped up into put in the pot with the abundant life. So you're not allowing yourself to really fully experience abundant life because you're in protection mode, when really the only person that can guard your heart is the Lord. Mm. Like, he doesn't just guard our heart from other people, but he guards our heart. Like, he guards us from ourselves.
Yes, he does.
You know? And you can't see yourself. And so the full job isn't even being done. You know, you're just trying to do the best you can. And it's that rejection thing. And that's it. You have to allow God to heal you. You have to allow God to heal you. And she was talking about, you know, some things are perception, some things really did happen. These things happen, but I decided to walk through it with a glaze over my eyes, because or get over it, right? And just be like,
yeah,
I'm fine. I'm okay. No, let's go. Let's do, you know, let's do worship, or I'm going to lead this. I'm going to do that. And I just think it's that whole thing of like, he has time, and he's about you being perfected in the end,
mm-hmm.
not you having your dream job at the end, or having this, and that, but you being perfected in the end. And it's all wrapped up into the process. Every time I think about that, I'm just so thankful that he allowed me to see. He revealed and he healed. That's God's never-ending cycle, revealing and healing.
Yep.
And revealing.
Whatever he reveals, he's ready to heal.
Yeah.
It's so good. And what you were sharing reminded me of just being a kid, and you fall and you hurt you scrape your knee and you are bleeding, but you'd rather keep riding your bike. So your parents are like, hey, come here for a minute. And we need to get this together. But you're so invested in the street lights are gonna come on. And I want to get these few more minutes in.
Yes.
But your parents are like, no. And then you feel like, oh, man, okay, fine.
Right.
But it actually puts you in a position to enjoy what you were trying to pursue by dealing with that wound.
Yeah.
And it's important for all believers to walk in wholeness. Because when we don't walk in wholeness, we're not walking in what John 10:10 talks about, the abundant life that Jesus came for us to receive, life and life in full.
Amen. Amen. And I want to say this, you know, we put too much trust in time.
Woo.
And just thinking like
time is the healer of all wounds.
Time may allow things to grow over it and may allow it to heal the wrong way. But when you add God into the pot and when you allow him to take control of time and healing, then it heals the right way. Because what happens when you just trust in time to heal your wounds, when you finally allow God to step in, sometimes there's a re-breaking that has to happen and a resetting so that it can heal the right way. And I think that me and Pastor Michelle can save you some time.
Come on here. Come on here. We're trying to give you some shortcuts tonight.
Listen, walk through it right now. And I will say this. I'm so much more sure that the people who say they love me really do love me because I introduced myself to them. You know, I wasn't sure. And that's what's so sad, is that there were so many people that were sure that they loved me. But I was so afraid of saying anything. I was so afraid of, you know, our relationship not being transactional, that I never really allowed that to happen. I never really allowed myself to receive love and community the way that God intended for it to be received and enjoyed. And so I just think that it's just another one of those things where you're missing out.
Yeah, I mean, you know, the way of the kingdom is, you know, it's give and it shall be given unto you.
Yeah.
And many of us are more comfortable with the giving part of it and then uncomfortable with the receiving part of it.
Absolutely.
And then some of us are really good at the receiving part.
Yes.
But not good at the giving part. You know, so either side is not what God has for us,
yeah.
Right? It's that we give and we receive, that there is a flow of his mercy, his grace, his goodness, his mm-hmm. provision mm-hmm. from us to others, but then from others to us too.
Yeah.
And so whichever side of the equation you find yourself on tonight, the Lord's given you an invitation right. to work with the flow of the Spirit in this season of your life because you're missing out. For those that love to receive but have a hard time giving affirmation, giving love, sowing into others, maybe you're okay with sowing into others when it comes to giving a gift or an act of service, but when it comes to giving your heart to others, you may be guarded. But
right.
this is an opportunity for your relationships, even your relationship with your children or your spouse or
so
friends
good.
Or colleagues, to deepen in a way where God can use you to be a source of encouragement and building others up, because I promise you, the Bible says give and it will be given unto you, pressed down, shaken together, and running over,
yeah.
right? But then the Bible also tells us that it's more blessed to give than receive.
Mm-hmm.
So when we are focused on what we receive, we're also cutting off heaven's resources coming to us, because there's a dimension that we enter into when we sow and when we give. And so I just challenge you tonight, if you find yourself more on what can this relationship bring to me? What can being with this guy or dating from all my single people, this woman dating or whatever, what can this relationship bring to me? I challenge you to find out how you can be a servant to that relationship.
That's good.
And see how that dynamic shifts into a healthier spiritual flow for your relationship.
That's good.
Because everything's birthed from the family.
That's
Everything
good.
We experience is birthed through the family,
yeah.
if you're a believer, right?
Yeah.
So God wants to work first in your home, in your heart, and then in your home, and then in your world.
Yeah, yeah. And I like how you brought it practical, because this is what I was going to say.
Come on here.
Well, this is what I was going to say. Like, you know, we could talk about this, like, oh, introduce the real you to people. But what does that practically look like, you know? I have friends now that, you know, when we talk on the phone, there is no conversation about what I'm able to do for them and what they're able to do for me. And this may sound really simple, but some of you listening don't know how to do that. You don't know how to have a conversation without there being some form of exchange,
mm-hmm.
right? You don't know how to have a relationship. And the truth is that exchanges happen naturally, not just the way that you're used to them happening, right? When I am on the phone with Pastor
yeah.
Michelle, sorry, I hit my mic. We might just be laughing the whole time. That is a beautiful exchange that happens, because in our line of work, or I should say in our ministry, we need to laugh. There's a lot of heavy stuff that goes on. And so make a decision to go out to tea with somebody and do not bring up work. Do not bring up, you know, what that person can, even if your relationship might be transactional in another setting, create settings for you to just have community and just talk and just, you know, talk about life or the pants you bought or the, you know what I mean?
I remember one time you FaceTimed me and I was eating. It was during the fast, y'all. We did our 40-day fast at the beginning of the year. And I found these impossible Jamaican patties.
Oh, yeah.
So she FaceTimed me, so I took the FaceTime, and I'm like, snacking. And she's like, what are you eating? Like, yes. I was going to town. And yes. So we had a full-on conversation about when she was vegan and the fast.
Yes, and that is something that I need in my life, you know?
So
those are just some practical things. Go for a walk with somebody. You know, I know this is, I'm not giving you a scripture right now, but it's all biblical, trust me. You know, you just need, you need some things in your life that are not connected to work. And I think a lot of us don't know how to do that. That's how you bring you to the table, is literally to just bring you to the table.
It's so important, because oftentimes we are skilled at certain things.
Right.
And we enjoy that we have that skill or that intellect or that ability. Mm-hmm. And a lot of our connections are related to that.
Most of them, yeah.
And that's important, because we do need to have advancement in our ability to produce for our family and things like that. I think about men in this aspect, because I know that men typically like to be able to fix things, progress, do more, excel, go to the next level, be effective. And so that's a part of their DNA, to provide, to protect, to advance, to conquer. But all of our relationships don't foster that element. Some are about the nurture and the comfort and the connection that we all need. And so, you know, one of the things that the Lord did in my life that was so important was to deal with wounds of the father. And my dad and I had so many rich conversations and deep moments of healing in our relationship in the last probably 5 years that he lived.
Yeah.
Because there were moments in his life as a young minister where he was protecting us. He was advancing the call of God on his life, the growing the ministry and pursuing godly things. But us girls were at home and we didn't have that time or his voice speaking into us at critical moments in our growing up. And so as an adult, there were things that were missing in my foundation, but the Lord was gracious to allow us to have those conversations so that I could see his perspective on it. Because many of us don't recognize, when we deal with wounds from our parents, that our parents were growing and maturing in Christ, maturing in their life, learning how to do things better, and that those gaps were not intentional.
Yeah.
You know?
And that it was their first time.
It was their first. I'm the oldest. Everybody's, it was their first time.
Literally.
And so they didn't know everything to be an expert the first time. But a lot of times what we can do on the receiving end, and I'm ministering to you at home right now.
Yes.
What we do is we hold people hostage to what we didn't receive.
That's so good.
Not healthy. We have to learn how to see things for the whole perspective. So even in your marriage, there are situations that have happened where there's been a level of unforgiveness and brokenness because there have been moments of great disappointment where you felt like you need the comfort of your spouse, or you felt like the words that were spoken were not appropriate to where you were emotionally, God wants to bring healing into your heart right now. If you'd be willing to release it to Him and allow Him to take up the space where holding on to that stuff resided. If you received that word, just lift your hands, because God wants to bring just His healing anointing, the balm of Gilead, right now. Amen. I just really believe that for you tonight. So, Lord, I thank You for every heart that has been holding on to things of the past, situations that happened, feeling a void, feeling not adequate, feeling that they don't have enough. God, I thank You that You are more than enough. God, we thank You that You fill up every cup to overflowing. And so, Lord, we just release Your fire, God, to burn up and to clear out all the gook and the gunk that has stayed there for over time because of resentment or bitterness or hurt or overlooked pain. God, we thank You that Your fire burns it out, but now Your fire of the Holy Spirit comes to fill and to quench all of the desires that would cause anyone to abandon or to divorce or to abandon their family. God, we thank You that they'll be led by godly desire, that they'll be led by healthy desire. And we thank You, God, even for single folks that are out here right now, Lord, that they'll be able to walk in the wholeness and the healing from releasing people to You and allowing the healing to flow. We thank You for these things in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.
Amen.
It's so crazy. This performance thing leads to so many avenues, doesn't it?
It does. It really does. And you said you can't hold people hostage to what you didn't receive.
Ooh,
and in that,
it's hard.
But it's so true, right? Yeah. Because as God healed me, there's that element of you got to forgive those people. And they're growing too.
They're growing too.
Maybe not in the things you wish, you know, that you thought maybe they should have already had it together, but everybody's journey is different. Everybody's upbringing is different, the things they're exposed to in life. And you just gotta forgive and just let them go. And also, you know, as a performer, that means that I can't go looking at everyone and thinking in my mind, do you really love me? Or, do you know what I mean? With that in the back of my mind, I can't have that in the back of my mind when I make relationships. I really have to get out of the protector's seat and allow God to just give me discernment.
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
Because a lot of us think that I hate to say it again because we already talked about it. We think our fears from past rejection are discernment, but they're just fear, and it's the wrong lens. You're never going to have real, genuine relationships if you're looking through the lens of your past hurt. But you got to let God get in the driver's seat, because the opposite of that is discernment. It's that prophetic anointing of God speaking to you. It's you knowing His voice, and it's you also being so set in Him loving you for who you are that no one else's perception of you can destroy that. So you're already set before you meet people, because He's healed that whole performance thing. You don't got to perform for Him. He's the one that matters. And so you're seeing through that lens, a lens of healing. So I just love how you touched on that.
Yeah, no, it's so powerful. I mean, the Lord has set His love upon us.
Yeah.
And so we have a choice to walk and know that love or to walk in the opposite direction, to walk in fear. Mm. And so I am just so grateful that you were willing to share transparently tonight and to let us into your world. And I love that you write songs from your own experience.
Have to.
Well, some people don't. I mean, some people want to be gangster rappers that never did grow up in the hood. I mean, you don't have anything gangster
about you.
You just
said a whole lot. I can't. I'll get found out.
You'll get found out and I wouldn't know anything about it. So anyway. So can't do that.
Yeah.
A path. But how many other songs have you written from like your own testimonies, your EP that reflects part of your journey?
Right. I think that all of them, I think probably one off of the EP is like a Brighter was this beautiful idea of just that, like, you know, everyone has this internal processor and how they process and express life. And that's really what your light is. That's what your light looks like. And you can shine that for selfish ambition, which the world wouldn't, you know, they wouldn't frown upon that because that's the way of the world.
What?
They'd be like, yes, you know, Or you can shine for the Lord and be other-centered, which to me enhances your light even more than the other way around. And so that was brighter, but all the other ones, like, take me back, you know. God, don't let this just become a routine. And if it has become a routine, don't let it stay a routine. Correct me. Wake me up. Help me to see. Good Now is all about the whole fear of missing God, you know?
Yeah, I didn't know that, but that's my favorite one.
Yes. It's like finally living, right?
Good Now, yeah.
Let's see. Finally living right side up. I was looking down for a minute. It's hard to see the sky from the forest when you're in it, right? When we're in this thing, like, it's really hard to see what God's doing, but he's looking, he has a different point of view. He has aerial view, that whole thing, right? Mm-hmm. I'm good now. I trust the Lord now. Everything's going to be all right. You've got I Try, which we already talked about. Got Hey You, which is about communication. It's all, writing songs is my life's journal. So I may not journal every day, but I am singing about what I'm learning and understanding about myself. And that's literally how I'm built as a human. Like, I've had moments where I felt sick until I sat down and wrote a song about it. And it was like, okay, now I understand, because sometimes I can just sing it better than I can say it. And so I have to, my grandmother said to me, it must minister to you before it can minister to anybody else.
That's the truth about preaching too, about teaching. It has to be a word that's delivered to you. Mm-hmm. It can't be from here. It's got to go from here to here so that there's life on it.
That's
there's
so good.
Life on it when it's been a word that's brought correction or healing to you, but there's no life on it mm-hmm. when it's just something you think to be right about who God is, because that's what takes it from logos, mm-hmm. the written word, the rhema, like the spirit
that's
has
good.
Breathed on it.
That's so good.
It's been tried. It's been tested. Mm. It's been proven to be effective. And that's what then takes up residence in you and becomes a part of your life as a believer and strengthens
you.
That's
so good.
So of course, your grandma's got some wisdom.
Yeah.
Well, this has been so fun, and I'm glad that you've been ministered to at home. So we're gonna let our worship team minister to you, and then we're going to come back and pray for you, and we'll close with generosity and announcements.
Lord, you're worthy of all the praise and all the glory. We worship you and you alone.
My worship.
So we're going to pray for you. You know, many of us recognize that we have room to grow. You know, that's one of the messages that I've heard in our conversation tonight, that we all have room to grow, room to move forward in God, and that whatever He's showing us in our life, He's ready to address it. He's ready to bring healing into our lives. And that may be through a relationship, a new friendship, but it also might be through His Word. And so I'm going to pray for you right now that you would have the courage to move beyond some of the immature places of handling your emotions and relationships, but truly seek the Father's wisdom for how to move forward, and so that you can really receive love and give love. And then however the Lord leads Doe to minister, she'll do that, and then we'll receive our offering. So Lord, I just thank you tonight. I thank you that you are working. Lord, that even when we don't see it, you're working. And even when we don't feel it, you're working. And Lord, we thank you that tonight you've pinpointed some things, some sources through which we seek to get validation. We seek to receive love. We seek to find ourselves positioned to receive the life that we think that you purchased for us. But Lord, we thank you that you show us, and you also transform us into another vessel so that you can use us and continue to progress us. I just see David as a picture, God, that you called him from his mother's womb to be a king, but he moved from the shepherd of tending sheep, and he moved to being the one who had slayed Goliath, but then he moved to the armor bearer. God, we thank you that in every season of our life, you're working by your sovereignty to perfect us. So Lord, we hone in on this area tonight, Lord, where the roots of rejection, where the spirit of rejection has come in to siphon off this true flow of love, not only that flows from your throne of grace, but that flowed from Calvary's tree. Lord, we thank you tonight for the love that so loved the world that you gave your only begotten son, that we would find you, that whosoever, God, we thank you that you didn't put a name on who would find you, that you didn't slay your son for a specific person or a specific racial group or a specific socioeconomic group, but God, you shed your blood on Calvary's tree for whosoever would believe. So tonight, Lord, we receive your love. We receive that overwhelming flow of acceptance and grace that was purchased for us. And Lord, we pray now that you would expose any place where rejection has crept in, or even a sense of needing to earn your love. Lord, help us to know your love fully, the love of the Father, the love that calls our spirit to cry out in recognition and bear witness that you are stirring and moving in our life. So Lord, we cancel every counterfeit assignment, every demonic influence, every familiar spirit that would seek to call to us and call us out of that place where we know that we're receiving that pure stream from your throne of grace in our prayer time, in our worship time. Amen. And Lord, we thank you that we hear your voice and another we do not follow. So we thank you tonight for your sovereignty and your providence. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Thank you, Lord. And again, God, we open our hearts to your healing.
Thank you, Lord.
The process of healing, God. And just as you have time for however long it's going to take for you to take us back to the beginning, walk us through until we're full and whole, God, we make a decision right now. Make a decision with me as I'm praying. We make a decision right now to make time for your healing. Because we have a way that we want it to happen. We want to look a certain way when it's happening. And God, we just say yes to however you want to do this thing, because your way is the best way, and we submit to you. We also, Lord, I feel like you want us to forgive. We forgive. There are names that are coming up in your spirit as I'm talking to you right now. And you just need to even make room for the process of forgiving. Did you know that forgiveness happens? It's a process as well. It's daily as those things keep trying to come up, making a decision. No, I forgive them, or I have forgiven them. Make time in your life for forgiveness, because there's so much more that God has for you to access. There's so much more in His will and in the abundant life and in relationship that God wants you to access, but you got to let go of the old and former things so you can grab a hold of the new things. You got to let go of the bad so you can grab a hold of the good. So much good God has for you. There's some of us that God wants to bring a man into our lives or a woman or a spouse, but we're so afraid and we're still performing that they wouldn't even meet the real us. Make a decision to let go of that person who you felt like people wanted to see and who you were presenting, and grab a hold of who you are and allow God to form and to shape you and to heal you. So we just say yes to you, God. And we trust you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. These are such sincere moments in the presence of God. And I pray for you at home that you take these moments and that you begin to enter in with an open heart with the Lord. It's so important, even as Doe was praying, to allow yourself to be open to what God would want to do,
amen.
How He wants to bring you into your new season. And we've been talking here at Hope that 2021 is the year of the King and Priest for our men, but it is also the year of great transitions. Mm. And so all change isn't bad. Mm. And really, I want you to know that God's moving you into your destined position this year. Mm. That all of the challenges that we're facing is so that we are like sword ready, battle ready.
Amen.
That we know exactly how to apply His word and for what. And so a lot of the tests and trials that we're facing that feel like so intense are the opportunities where we are now like sword ready with the word too. Okay. So I want you to just allow the Lord to have your full heart in this time. Hold nothing back.
Amen.
So that when we come on the other side of transition, we are all arrayed as His bride to go to the next place. So I just love you at home, Hope Christian Church family. This is awesome to come together, to grow together. And so that is our goal, that what will be said of this church is that you are well taught in the Lord. Mm. So that's our mission in our heart, to turn your heart to God, to develop you to win in every area of your life, and to advance God's kingdom. So I'm going to encourage you in your giving tonight. We believe that the Lord wants to advance His agenda through our lives. And we want to utilize our resources, even our wealth, not just our gifts, our talents, and our time, and our families, even to push the mission and vision of God for our lives forward, but also our finances. And in a society right now where it's being prophesied that the economy is going to have problems, where you see like our new president is spending trillions of dollars, many of us are thinking, well, where is he going to get this money from? Me? My taxes? I know I'm not the only person who's thought that thought. But even in challenge and change with the economy, we have to remember that we as kingdom people are a part of God's economy. Mm. And that He has cattle on a thousand hills. Mm-hmm. That He has resources that the earth has not even seen yet. Mm-hmm. Because the earth is the Lord's and the fullness therein. And I think the fullness includes the finances. Wherever you may be thinking, you know, tax time has been extended, so you may be having to file your taxes at a different time this year based on different COVID things. We all have different financial struggles, but we are part of the kingdom of God, and He has the resources that we need at the appropriate time. So let's stay in alignment and moving in generosity and moving with tithes and offerings, because there's a kingdom blessing and a spiritual blessing that comes upon it. Malachi 3:10 tells us that He'll rebuke the devourer for our sake, but that He also pours out blessings and opens windows. So I know that many of us do need that open heaven over us, because our kids are going to college, because we're ready to retire, because of so many things. And so I want to pray for you that with the seeds that you have sown over time, that you'll enter into the time where the harvest overtakes the reaper if you do not faint. So, Lord, I thank you, Lord, for every person under the sound of my voice. Yes. Lord, I thank you for every giver. We give generously because we know that we are giving to you, that we are giving a portion of what we've received from you, saying that everything that we've received from you is yours. It still pertains to you because we are just stewards. Everything we have has been given to us to be good stewards of. So Lord, we thank you, God, that you are providing for us. So for those who are in those transition steps in this year of great transition, Lord, I pray that your open heaven would be over them, Lord, that you would pour out blessings upon them, Lord, that they would have the sense that, oh my goodness, I can't even contain the joy of the Lord satisfying me with good things. Lord, I thank you that you satisfy them with sweet things, Lord, with the honey and the honeycomb. So Lord, we thank you that even this time we will see your faithfulness, your mercy, and your grace upon the givers of this house to be a blessing and to advance your kingdom. So we thank you that we will not faint. Amen. We will not grow weary. We will not agree with the voice of the media or the voice of opposition to the promises of God. We thank you that you have said that we will be lenders and not borrowers, and we will be above. So Lord, we thank you that that will be true in this time, and we thank you that the harvest will overtake the reaper and that we will see it in real time. In Jesus' name we pray, amen and amen. This has been so fun.
Yeah, it has.
So here's what I want you to do, is because this is the official end of our service, right? I want you to go to our website and click on give, thehopeconnection.org, and click give if you want to give in the offering. You can text HCCGIVE to 77977, or you can mail a check or a money order or whatever you'd like to P.O. Box 505, College Park, Maryland, 20741. And so I would love for you to write me an email this week, if you can, of a testimony of what God's been doing in your life. You can email me at info@thehopeconnection.org. I'd love to hear how God's been moving in your heart, how you've been receiving from the ministry of this church, because I know that God is building his people in this hour and in this church. So be bold. Let's share. Let's encourage one another. Y'all know when I've received the testimonies, I share, and I don't tell it who it was. So you don't have to be concerned about your situation being exposed. But I do know that God's been doing some incredible things in this time, and that it would be a blessing for others to hear what God's been doing in your heart, in your life. So, Doe, where can we find your music? Tell everybody where to find your music.
Yes, you guys can find my music on every musical streaming platform, whether it's YouTube, Google Play, Amazon Music, Apple Music, Spotify, whatever your choice of platform is, it's out there. You guys can follow me at Doe Jones Music on Instagram and book me at doejonesmusic.com. But everything is pretty much on my Instagram. You'll find everything you need, the music, the content. And yeah, that's it.
Thank you so much for being here tonight.
Thank you for having me.
All right, so this is the official end of our service. We love you with the love of the Lord. May the Lord cause his face to shine upon you.
Amen.
And give you peace today and every day for the rest of your life. We love you. We'll see you on Sunday or next week. Good night.